Let's have a look, see what we're dealing with, eh?
Kiwi parents spend daylight hours in their den, taking turns to incubate the enormous egg.
Have a look.
Oh my goodness. I'm very lucky in my job that I get to see kiwi a lot, but every time I see one, I still get that same sense of magic. They're like nothing else in the world.
To recover the egg, Ian must crawl into the burrow. Careful management is critical to the chick's survival.
Basically, if it doesn't get sat on again or warmed up within the 24 hours, it's likely that that egg will die.
Yeah.
We'll see how we go.
The parent kiwi retreat, leaving the egg exposed.
I guess our biggest challenge is collecting that egg without causing too much stress to the bird. If the birds don't move off the egg, there's a chance that they can kick or potentially put a hole or a crack in that egg.
His contortion skills come in handy.
Nearly there.
Ian is well aware that two pairs of powerful legs armed with sharp claws are very close. It's nearly 10 times larger than a chicken's egg, and handling with care is critical. The embryo can be easily damaged.
You get it?
Yep, got it. Wow. It was a pretty special moment to be handed a real live kiwi egg. But it also meant a lot of responsibility, so I was focusing as hard as I could on making sure I didn't, you know, jiggle the egg too much.
So what we're looking for in general is just any cracks in the egg surface. If there's a crack in there, we need to transport it basically crack side up, because we don't want anything spilling out of the egg.
Yeah.
There we go.
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
You can see that air still.
Yeah.
So that also tells me that this is the egg's upright.
So basically, we just want to smooth the ride out as we can.
Yeah.
This is quite an enormous egg for a relatively small bird.
Yeah.
Is this about standard for these chicks?
For roe, average is around 400 grams. So you're looking about 20% of the weight of the female when it's laid.
No other bird carries an egg of such enormous size in relation to its body mass. By the time it's ready to be laid, the egg is so large that the mother's body doesn't even have space for food. The egg also has a higher proportion of yolk than other bird eggs. It can sustain the chick for up to 80 days before it hatches, more than twice the usual incubation period for a bird. This chick is ready, and the long process of hatching has begun. Kim imitates a parent bird to test the chick's responses.
Gobbles.
I can hear them.
Little tiny little squeaks.
Amazing. On average, it takes 5 or 6 days to fully hatch. The hatching process is slow because, unlike most other chicks, kiwi lack an egg tooth, a lump on the top of their beak to help them break the shell. But that extra time in the egg is one of the secrets of the kiwi's success. Most bird chicks are born blind and helpless. Kiwi chicks emerge developed and able to fend for themselves. Chicks are raised at the centre for the first 3 to 4 weeks of their lives. During that time, they'll double their weight.
So here's this wee fella.
This is Wisp, the roe chick. Wisp is 29 days old today, so nearly a month of age. Doing very, very well.
You can really see how they kind of pop out ready to go, can't you? He's like just a perfect miniature of an adult.
The kiwi's long gestation period gave it a head start over bird species hatching helpless chicks. But did it sacrifice its ability to fly in order to carry these uniquely massive eggs?
Because kiwi don't fly, they don't have wings, but they do actually have sort of wings.
They do. There's a vestigial wing. Here's our wing tucked under there.
The tiny claw.
Tiny little claw right on the tip there next to
it. It's got something very unusual that no other bird has, right?
Very unusual. So kiwi nostrils are right at the tip of this bill here, of this beak. If you'll notice, and a little oval just here. That's the end of her nostrils. So there's two hollow tubes that run across the top there. So they'll push those nostrils underground and sniff and snuffle and find their dinner.
Back on the west coast of New Zealand's South Island, Department of Conservation Ranger Ian Graham and Threatened Species Ambassador Nicola Torkey are headed back into the Okarito wetlands. Two Rui kiwi chicks, who had been living in a predator-free sanctuary, have come of age. They are now old enough to defend themselves against predators and can be released into their home forest.
6 years ago, it was extremely critical. We had probably less than 200 individuals remaining on the planet. And in the last 6 years, we've been able to more than double the population through the Operation Nest Egg program. We're certainly not out of the woods, and they're still going to need all the kind of TLC we can give them, but it's really nice to be part of a program that is on the way up. So this one's properly on its own now.
Yeah, he is.
Yeah, yeah. Off to the wild.
By looking at the kiwi as a bird that tried to become a mammal, its unique biology starts to make sense.
There he goes.
Once it flew to New Zealand, the kiwi followed the example of the moa and eventually lost the use of its wings.
Here we go.
New Zealand's national symbol was originally a visitor that decided to stay. Thankfully, the Rui population is stabilising and this remarkable bird's chances are looking up.
They are only found here in New Zealand. They are like nothing else in the world. And there's just something about them that, you know, makes you want to pull out all the stops to protect them.